Those of you who fly with X-plane know how difficult and squirrely it is to be able to steer on the ground some of the smaller aircraft such as this SR-22. And you must be wondering how I'm doing such a good job, given that this is a freely castering nose wheel and it doesn't really steer too well. So there's a trick to do it. You don't need to invest in a rudder pedal with toe brakes or something like that, but you need to give up your castering nose wheel if you want to be able to steer accurately on the ground like this. Or here, watch me approaching the end of this narrow 75 foot wide runway, and I'm going to try to turn in half that width and take off at the same time. And I have enough steering control to be able to do that. Just watch. Okay. Now let me show you how to do this. You start by going into the X-plane 12 directory in your PC and double click on the plane maker executable, not the X-plane 12 executable. There's another .exe file in there called plane maker. Just double click on that to start it up. Next, you go to the file menu, you do an open, you navigate to the folder where the aircraft is that you're interested in, and then you open the .acf file for that aircraft, like I'm doing right here. Double click on the ACF file, and now just wait for that file menu to disappear. Unfortunately, the screen capture is not capturing the top line of the menu, but after the file menu disappears, you go to the second menu and you pick up landing gear. And this is what you're going to see. Now you can see three columns in the landing gear. The first one is for the nose wheel. The second and the third are for the left and right landing gear, main landing gear if I'm not mistaken. We're not interested in the second and third column. Our only interest is the first column. All the way at the end of the first column, right at the bottom, there's a green check mark, a green box next to caster. We need to take that green box out by clicking on it so that the front wheel no longer casters freely. Next, I find the row about third row up from the bottom that says N-W steering, low and high speed. N-W means nose wheel. So I'm going to set the nose wheel steering at low speed to 45 degrees by clicking the up arrow next to the digit boxes, and I'm going to set the high speed steering to 10 degrees using the up arrow keys. Once those settings are done, you go back to the file menu and click on save. And finally, you have to go back to the file menu and click on quit. Now here I am moving my joystick left and right, and that's how I get some rudder control. I don't have a rudder pedal, and let's see how that affects the nose wheel. I'm going to twist my joystick again, 45 degrees left and 45 degrees right, very smoothly, and I'll show you from another angle how the rudder moves with the nose wheel. Left and right. And I'm all set for that smooth ground control.